How did we get here? Half the year has passed, but moments ago I was in my kitchen making pancakes from oats on Shrove Tuesday, thinking about talking about fasting versus choosing, thinking about the concept of using up, thinking about how when you spend the first 14 or 15 years of your life celebrating Lent, it's hard to get out of the habit, and how Lenten meant spring or long day. Trying to make my way out of the nothing. That sugar disappearing into the lemon. I want to be in my old kitchen, blue tiles and bright red brick arch into a small room with orange washed paint, British countertops and Mexican colour schemes. I can hear myself asking for a Mickey Mouse hot cake, please. From March through to mid-July, I cooked from the Middle Eastern vegetarian cookbook when I cooked at all, and I didn't cook much. And where am I now? I'm in the dark. I never think to make my own seasoning, but so many recipes in this book called for 7-spice seasoning that I followed the instructions, distilled its 7 parts, and then brought them together. The contents of that spare NutriBullet jar is at the centre of so much I made during this time. Fresh dishes I wouldn't think to spice, breads warm from the oven. Tabbouleh is a Syrian and Lebanese dish. It comes from the mountain regions. Its origin is found in the words for seasoning or dip. How fitting that it was the first thing I made with my 7-spice seasoning. The onions made me cry a lot today. I just made a big bowl of the green lentil tabbouleh from the Middle Eastern vegetarian cookbook. Today was an interesting one because I messed up a lot today. I don't know, something about today, like even though nothing catastrophic happened, felt like a really bad work day. And really, you know, that's all me piling that onto myself. That's not anyone else. It's just frustrating when I feel like I can't do my job well. When my head just takes over and I don't feel like I can do it well. It just gets really overwhelming to just keep swimming. You know, I just keep thinking of that train. I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. That's what it's like. I really don't want these to be gloomy. Time spent in dark corners, flashes strung together of bad days like the imperceptible threads of a cobweb. For one, it feels self-indulgent. For two, I want these to be stories of victory and glory, the story of how cooking fixed it all, my former enemy, my best friend. I continue to seek for a solution, even when I pretend I've outgrown that. I still want it to stop, and playing in that realm makes me feel like a child. The past few months I could barely be in front of the camera. Every part of me felt like it was swollen, taking up too much room, repulsive, grotesque. On the days I was above water, I tried to prepare for when I was pulled back down by making a lot, making bright things that would live in my fridge and entice me. Often it felt like I was cooking a banquet for ghosts, but I didn't know whether the ghost was me, or everyone else I couldn't speak to, or things that had been left behind. As usual, the strange thing is, there were a lot of days that were completely wonderful. I spoke to friends, went to work, travelled to beautiful places, read books, pored over the new albums by favourites, but then I'd come back to the kitchen, or the Skype call would end, or I'd catch a reflection, or time difference cut off a text conversation, and it would be back. reminding me that it in fact had never left. I was really frustrated when looking through my videos over the past few months to find that I had not looked at the camera and talked about my day, talked about what I was feeling, what was going on in my brain, other than that one day, but then realised that too said something. Seasonings and spices aside, this month featured a lot of lemons. When pressed in the great debate, I will always pick limes, but lemons were there, again and again and again. I was given lemons, but I could not make Beyoncé's lemonade. Looking back, if I'm to find a metaphor in this or something to cling on to, I'd say that you could never quite get all of the lemon juice out, or that sometimes it feels like you've been turning around and around forever, or that lemon preserves, it keeps the colour, or that we associate lemons with acidity, but also with some of the sweetest things that we drink. There are so many directions to go. Possible sunshine, possible sharpness. But I didn't see any of this while I was going through it. While I was going through it, I was going through the motions, appreciating the method of it and the time that I had put aside to make and to take care of myself, whether that was the present or the future self. But I was never really there. I didn't feel the presence and present. I felt distant from myself these past few months, and I don't know what the solution is there, nor the cause. I just know that it's helpful to look back at this and see the colour and what I've missed, and while knowing that some of that is externally added, and all of it is framed through the frame I choose, there is still something there to talk about, still something there to celebrate. Still a meal, a banquet in fact, to be laid out. Whether or not my attendees are people or ghosts.